Beat 103.
Hi Sarah, how are you doing?
Hi, thanks Jodie, how are you?
Yes, I'm good, thank you very much. Now, I've had a little look through what we're talking about today and it looks great.
Yeah.
It's all about the Greek islands, yes.
They're amazing, aren't they? Aren't those pictures beautiful?
It looks amazing. So can you tell us how many islands there are exactly and what visitors can expect?
Well, if you're anything like me, I adore Greece and I've been to loads of the islands by now. Every year I try and go back to a different one because there's so many. I didn't actually realise how many there were. There's 1,200 to 6,000. That's a lot, but the actual number of inhabited islands varies between 166 and 227.
Okay.
But that's still a lot. You've got the main ones that people think of, so things like Santorini, Mykonos, Rhodes, Kos, Corfu, Crete, you know, the ones that you hear of for holidays. What I've done was top 20 Greek islands to explore. The Greek islands, it's got the most beautiful, bluest of waters, dazzling white villages and miles of sandy beaches. So whether you're looking to try a bit of Greek island hopping, which is quite popular, or you're just searching for one island to go put the flip-flops down and just literally chill for a week, the choice is yours. Whether it's families or foodies, there's something for everybody. And they're all really easy to reach from all the UK airports as well. You're talking anything from 3.5, maybe a 4-hour flight, something like that. So you've got so much to offer. You've got all the ancient history. You've got the Mediterranean culture. The amount of Brits that visit Greece every year, on average, is 3 million.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's a lot. Top islands to visit, you ask anyone, they'll have their own personal opinion. If I just pick out a few that I've been to off the top 20, the number one probably has to be Corfu. Did you watch The Durrells at all?
I didn't know.
Right, well, The Durrells was based on Corfu. The family went to Corfu, I think it was just before the Second World War. It's really, really good. But it's more important, the fact it just shows you what Corfu would have been like back then. So it's number one in the top 20, influenced by past Venetian, French and British rule. It's got some of the most stunning towns. So you can go to Mouse Island, the Corfu town, and on many other sites to go and visit as well.
What would you say are the top islands to visit apart from that?
I'm not going to give you all 20, but there is going to be a full guide on this on the Facebook page after the show. But Santorini is up there. I went to Santorini about 18 months ago. It's actually number two, and it's the best Greek island for couples. I've got to agree with that. I went with my husband. We didn't have any children with us. It's the most beautiful, beautiful island. It actually owes its dramatic scenery to a volcano, which erupted in the 16th century. So if you go to Thera or Ea, which is spelled O-I-A, but you actually say ear, think of your ear on this side. The towns are built on the caldera of the volcano, so the views are just simply stunning. I just can't put into words how beautiful it is. And there is literally hundreds and hundreds of people that go to watch the sunset at Ea, and it amazed me. It was incredible. There's loads of other ones. You could go on forever. You've got Lindos, Rhodes is beautiful. Skopelos, if anyone's watched Mamma Mia, that's where they filmed it. It's the most beautiful Greek island is Skopelos. You've got the picturesque main town. You've got the chapel where they did the film. Mykonos, that's in there. Xanthi, that's best for spotting the sea turtles, which are just incredible creatures. And if you're really lucky, you can watch the little babies go into the sea, which is something quite special.
Do you have any offers for us today?
I certainly do. So I've got four offers today. These are all based on Manchester flights. The first one we have is in Kos. It's 7 nights from the 7th of July, bed and breakfast, $426 per person. And then I've got some bargains. If I had a credit card, I would have booked one of these. We've got the Corfu Village with EasyJet holidays, 7 nights from the 6th of July. This is unbelievable. £263 per person.
Wow.
Yeah. You've got one in Crete, the Dia apartment, same day, £274 per person. And the last one, I got a fantastic deal on all inclusive actually, which is a 5-star. It's the Remondi Grand Resort and Spa in Crete. 7 nights for just $467 per person.
Fantastic. People can have this information at their fingertips.
Of course, yes. So they can go onto the Beat Radio website, beatradio103.co.uk. And if you go onto the Beat Travel page, they'll see there's links on there. I've put on both my Facebook page, my YouTube channel, and also my travel show group on Facebook. And the travel show group is where they will find the 15 page guide to Greece, including all of the islands in the top 20 and the best things to do as well.
Thank you very much, Sarah. We will speak to you again next week.
You certainly will. Thank you very much. Have a lovely weekend, JD.
This is Beat 103. Beat 103. Preston.